Hi there, this is Dr. Mohin Haseeb again with lesson 2 on equality indicator, everything you need to know. If you recall, in lesson 1, we talked about what is a quality indicator, what are the key characteristics of an ideal indicator, what are the types of indicators, why measure, how many, okay, and where do you start. In lesson 2, we'll talk about implementing your quality indicator plan. How do you choose specific strategies to make your quality program succeed? How to evaluate? How to use information collecting to fuel your quality indicator process and a subject summary? So let's start with lesson 2. Implementing your quality indicator plan. There are 8 steps to developing and implementing successful quality indicator. You need an objective, and in an objective, you need to ask yourself the following question. What are you trying to measure? Why am I collecting this information? You need to be very specific. You need to talk about the method, how to capture the data, what data need to be captured, who or what to capture the data, how often to capture the data? Is it achievable as far as time, resources, and revenues? Also, you need to talk about the limits. Can I present levels for acceptable, concerns, unacceptable, critical? Next, presentation. Is it going to be presented as a text or a graphic? The interpretation. What does it mean? What does it reflect on your quality? Can I compare it? Can I trend it? Also, limitation for unintended variables, what does it mean? Action plan. What will I do if the indicator have acceptable performance? What will I do if it doesn't? Exit plan. When can I stop monitoring? This is just a picture of the same thing. So to develop and implement indicators, first you need to select indicator, the type of indicators, either pre-analytical, analytical, and post-analytical, which are usually process or income indicators. Some examples of pre-analytical indicators that you might want to be considered in your laboratory This is a list of them. I mentioned a couple of them here. Patient identification and its accuracy, blood culture contamination, order in test is appropriate for patient care, or rejected sample, okay? Also, you can consider that. This is also a list of pre-analytical indicators. And if you are interested in doing any of them, if you need. Okay, this is another list. For analytical phase indicators, this is a list of them, like accuracy of point of care testing or missed follow-ups, or QC failure or misdiagnosis, things like that. For post-analytical indicators, this is a list of them. Okay, a list of some post-analytical indicators. I'm going to mention just a couple of them, like critical value reporting, turnaround time, customer satisfaction. And this is another list of post-analytical indicators. And this is a list of indicators. Okay, it gives you the denominator, the denominator, and the measurements, if you're interested. Okay, next, we said to develop and implement an indicator, we select the indicator type, pre-analytical, analytical, and post-analytical. Let's take an example here, okay? So we're gonna, let's say if we wanna do the turnaround time stat, the turnaround time for a stat test in ER, okay? So what is the objective of the indicator? What are you trying to measure? Why am I collecting this information? What is my collection method? Be specific. Who's responsible? How often? And for how long? Okay, so the objective will be percentage of ER tests that meet and positive or does not meet negative reporting deadlines. Okay, as you know, that the turnaround time for laboratories are from receiving or received in the lab till result reporting. For doctors and nurses, they like from order to reporting. But in the lab, we measure the turnaround time from received to result reporting. Next, we're going to talk about the methodology. So we selected the indicator, the stat turnaround time in ER. Now we're going to talk about the methodology, how to capture the data. What data need to be captured? All stat samples from ER. Who or what to capture the data? Here you need to determine, is it the supervisor, the quality officer, the manager? Okay, how often you need to capture the data? Say monthly. Is it achievable as far as time and resources? Does the supervisor or the manager have time to collect the data or not, for example? Next, we're gonna talk about limits, goals, threshold, target, benchmark. Though they don't mean the same thing, but for our purposes, they mean the same thing. You need to have a limit, you need to have a goal, you need to have a benchmark in order to compare your collected data with. Okay, so the question you need to ask, do I have a current performance baseline? If you don't, you need to establish your own limit from your lab past performance, or you can collect data. If you don't have anything at all, you can collect data for a month, maximum 2 months. Then you can see where you are. Okay, let's say if the turnaround time for stat tests from ER, let's say if it were at 70%, you don't go and set your goal or your limit as 90%. Make it 75, then gradually increase. Okay, increase it to, for example, increase it to 75, increase it to 80, to 90, till you reach your goal. Okay, are any existing benchmarks or benchmarks from the accreditation body or universally known? For example, the blood culture contamination is 3% or less. You can go lower, but you cannot go higher than that. You have to comply with that. Okay, even if your baseline is 10, you need to keep your benchmark for blood culture contamination at 3%. Can I represent levels of for acceptance, concerned, unacceptable, or criticals? Okay, for example, here in a couple of hospitals, they did this study for the turnaround time for ER test, and in one of them, they were in compliance 89%, okay, 89% within 60 minutes, and in another study, they were at 85% within 60 minutes. Remember, turnaround time need percentage and need time, need percentage and need time. So your goal should be, okay, for example here, we set our goal, 90% done within 60 minutes. So you need a percentage and you need a time. Once you reach, you cannot do anything with the percentage, you can lower your timing, for example. So if you reach 97% within 60 minutes and you cannot improve that anymore, maybe you can make it 97 within 50 minutes or within 45 minutes. You keep doing that till you cannot really do any improvement with that indicator. At that moment, you can either stop monitoring, or if it's required by the accreditation body, you still need to monitor. And I will talk a little bit more about that in the next few slides. So our goal will be 90% done within 60 minutes. So how am I gonna present this? They say a picture is worth 1,000 words. Okay, I like to present it in a graph with columns, okay? A graph in bar graph like this, because it's easy to see and manage. data reporting plan. Who will receive the result? Is it just the, you're going to send it to quality of the hospital? You're going to post it on your bulletin board or storyboard? Or you need to send it to your laboratory director? Okay. How often will result be provided? Monthly, weekly? Okay. So at the end, you will have something like this. Okay. I like this template that we developed that has 13 months. So you can compare current month with the last year month. And then you have 12 months data. And also on the second page, you need to comment on the performance of your indicator. Like say if you meet your goal or your limit, you can say goal met or achieved, will continue to monitor. If it was not met, then you see goal was not met, and you need to mention the reasons why it was not met, and you need to have a corrective action. Now, if you want to increase your limit or your goal, for example, from 90% to 95% within 60 minutes, you can write, we will try to improve our performance. We will increase our limit or goal from 90 starting next month, from 90% within 60 minutes to 95% within 60 minutes. Interpretation, you need see information where others see data. Okay? What does it mean? Does it reflect on your quality? Can I compare it? Can I trend it? 90% done within 60 minutes. Is it good or bad? It's good, but it could be better. Limitation. Okay. Limitations mean unintended variables. What does it mean? It means that you might have outliers due to transportation, redraws, dilution, repeat issues with the specimen, instrument, technologies, etc. An outlier should be excluded from the calculation, okay? Or if you have a lot of them and you want to do something about the outliers, you can say this is the indicator with the outliers. This is how it looks, and usually it looks bad. Okay, and this is the indicator without the outliers. So we have to take care of the outliers. Maybe you can do an indicators about the outliers also. Okay, number 7, action plan. Act on the information. It's not what you find, it's what you do about what you find. Okay, what will I do if it does not indicate acceptable performance? Okay. If it does not meet your performance, then you need a corrective action, okay? Corrective or preventive action is needed. Remedial, that means you need immediate action, okay? Corrective action to remove root cause, and preventive is like a proactive things. Before it's broken, you fix it. So if your indicator is not meeting the goal or the limit, you need a corrective action by stating why. You need to look why we are not meeting, and you need to eliminate or take or reduce that source of problems for you. Okay, to remove that issue in order to meet your goal. What will I do if it does, like I told you just a couple of minutes ago, if it meets, either I keep continue monitoring, or if there is a room for improvement, I can improve either by increasing my percentage or decreasing my time. What will I do if it does, to monitor or not to monitor? Okay, so continue to monitor, like I said, or stop monitoring. You could stop monitoring if there is no room for improvement. You can stop monitoring, but you cannot stop monitoring if it's required by the accreditation. I already told you that. I need you to keep that in mind. So you only can stop monitoring if it's something that you initiated and you cannot improve anymore, and you look for another opportunity for improvement. Or like I said, you can modify your target or your limit, challenge yourself, but make sure the challenge is realistic and it's achievable. How do I decide? You decide based on what I I told you. If it's if it is needed for by accreditation body, you must keep. You can see if there is room for improvement, you can improve. If there is no room for improvement, then you can stop and try something else. The exit plan, when can I stop monitoring? Okay, you need to work smart, not hard. I already told you when to exit. Keep in mind, no garbage in, no garbage out. Quality testing starts at the very beginning, pre-analytical, and ends at the very end, post-analytical. Quality indicator must measure what matters, okay? So indicators, reports should include objective, method, limits, interpretation, limitation, presentation, action plan, and exit plan. At the end, you should have something like that or something like that. I like this better. Every little piece count in the process. Every little piece count in the process. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Everyone almost can have paint, can have boards, can have brushes. But does everybody can do this with the brushes and the board and the paint? Of course not. That's when the finish value is greater than the sum of the parts. That's when you transfer data into information. This is data, this information. Information makes sense. Information makes sense. So how to evaluate? Now we're going to talk about how to evaluate. Interrupt and present your information. Act, evaluate, evaluated. Take action, identify opportunity for improvement, rank these opportunities, set your priority right, evaluate your action, follow up on the actions, evaluation effectiveness, revise plan as needed with document control. Every time you revise, you need to write, why did you do it? Repeat the cycle again till you achieve your goal. Remember, not everything that be counted counts, and not everything that counts can be counted. For example, ethics, specimen sit in the lab, not received in the computer, and when the doctor or the nurse calling about the result, you start swearing and saying, no, I just receive it. Okay, I just receive it. Okay, despite that, it was sitting on the counter and you did not receive it. So we need to keep that in consideration also. At the end, you need to have quality indicators. Don't get tied to your indicators. An indicator you keep as long as it provides value. If it does not provide value, there is no need to keep. Okay? How to choose specific strategies to make your quality indicator program succeed? Need to have clear policies and procedures, need management commitment, assigned responsibilities, and have continuous supervisory oversight and monitoring. Need planning, setting realistic goal, challengeable yet attainable. Need to engage the people, staff at all level who do the work to be involved because they know what they are doing. Encourage a spirit of continuous improvement and effective communication among staff by providing feedback, training, opportunity to make suggestions for improvement, and an understanding of the benefits. Even if you are on the right track, you will run over if you just sit there. You need to keep moving. You need to keep moving. You need interdepartmental cooperation, total commitment from all parties to make work as a true team to improve the quality of specimen collection, transportation, processing, and resulting. Doctors, nurses, technologists, phlebotomists, staff, managers are all into this together. You need to present your approved, reviewed, evaluation, and feedback in your monthly meeting or quality report, like supervisor for supervisor board quality department staff etc. Okay, share the good and the bad and the ugly. Post it on your bulletin board or on your storyboard. Only together we can achieve improvement that none can achieve alone. Conclusion. Monitoring quality in all procedure and processes, the total testing process is impossible without the use of clinical or quality indicators. They create the basis for quality improvement and set the priority in the healthcare system. Quality indicator data should be collected over time to identify, correct, and continuously monitor problems and improve performance and patient safety. Clinical indicators should be valid and sensitive to the events and changes they are intended to detect. Quality indicators done well will consume more time than you think. Make sure you have goals that are realistic, but challengeable yet achievable. Write down what exactly you want to measure, how exactly you want to measure, what exactly are you going to do with the information, and what do what you can. لازم عيدها. Do what you can do. Don't bother with the rest yet. I am done with the quality indicators subject. Everything you need to know about that, I already told you. I hope it was beneficial for you. For the next subject, please go to calibration, verification, and linearity, the know how. Thank you for watching.